Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today in this video we are going to learn about the Planck constant value, that is h equals to 6.25 into 10 to the power minus 34 by using the Planck constant measuring instrument. Explain the theory that we learn from this experiment using Planck constant measuring instrument. So as we know, it was observed that as early as 1905 that most metal under influence of radiation emit electrons. This phenomena was termed as a photoelectric emission. The detailed study of this phenomena has shown that the emission process depends strongly on frequencies of radiation. For each metal there exists a critical frequency such that light of lower frequencies is unable to liberate the electron, while light of higher frequency always does. So the emission of electrons occurs within a very short time interval. After interval of the radiation and number of electron is strictly proportional to the intensity of the radiation. Now I will discuss the different parts of this kit. Later on I will explain and perform the experiment on this kit. So this is the Tesca's kit, that is Planck constant measuring instrument, order code 19204401.10. In this kit we also provide different accessories such as this one, and also we provide a manual for easify the performance of experiment. Now I will going to explain brief description of apparatus required in this experiment. So this is basically a light source, 12 volt 35 volt halogen tungsten lamp. This is a guide. Move the light source along with this distance between light source and dark box chamber can be adjusted. And we provide a scale of 40 centimeter length, a draw tube. So this is the Tesca's kit, that is Planck constant measuring instrument, order code 19204401.10. In this kit we also provide different accessories such as this one, and also we provide a manual for easify the performance of experiment. Now I will going to explain brief description of apparatus required in this experiment. So this is basically a light source, 12 volt 35 volt halogen tungsten lamp. This is a guide. Move the light source along with this distance between light source and dark box chamber can be adjusted. And we provide a scale of 40 centimeter length, a draw tube. In this we also have a draw tube. The fore part is used for installing color filter. Focus lens is fixed in the back end. Cover used to cover chamber containing photo tube. Focus lens make a clear image of light source on the cathode area of photo tube. Focus lens is installed in the draw tube. The four part. This is a draw tube. The four part is used for installing the color filter, and focus lens is fixed in the back end. We also provide a cover used to cover the chamber containing photo tube. Also, we provide a vacuum tube. You can see it is inside the chamber. This is a manual switch, that is on and off switch. Basically this is an indicator which indicates the switch is on or off. It is a voltage direction. We can decelerate the voltage and also accelerate the voltage. And it is a voltage adjuster to adjust the voltage. It is a light intensity. Using this, the halogen light is intense or bright. This is a current multiplier which multiplies the current, and this is a digital meter. In this digital meter we also see the current value and the voltage value. These are the different parts of accessories. Basically this is a screwdriver to unscrew the chamber box. These are the different filters. On these filters different wavelengths are returns. For this, for example, this is a blue filter. So for blue filter 460 nanometer wavelength is given on this filter, you can see. This is a cover for the draw tube. So let's we start the experiment using this kit, Planck constant measuring instrument. So now I will explain the procedure using this manual. First of all, insert the red color filter of 635 nanometer as is written on this filter. So fix this filter in this draw tube. Now we will on the power switch, set the light intensity at a strong light by using this knob. And the voltage direction switch at negative as shown in this kit. And display mode on the current direction, in the current direction. So now adjust to deaccelerating voltage to 0 volt using the voltage adjuster and current range selector at 0.001. So you can see we have to select at 0 volt. So this is a 0 volt using this voltage adjuster and current multiplier switch at 0.001. So current multiplier switch at 0.001. Now using this display mode switch, take it to the current direction. Okay, now increase the deaccelerating voltage to decrease the photocurrent to 0. So here voltage at 0. Now using this display mode switch, take it to the again to the voltage and it is showing minus 0.28. it is a stopping potential where photocurrent is 0 microampere. So now take down the stopping potential corresponding to 0 current of 635 nanometer wavelength. Similarly get the Vs of other wavelength in the same way. So now these are the different reading which is shown in this observation table. So for red filter, stopping potential minus 0.34. Now using this display mode switch, take it to the again to the voltage and it is showing minus 0.28. it is a stopping potential where photocurrent is 0 microampere. So now take down the stopping potential corresponding to 0 current of 635 nanometer wavelength. Similarly get the Vs of other wavelength in the same way. So now these are the different reading which is shown in this observation table. So for red filter, stopping potential minus 0.34. this stopping potential is measured by using this instrument. So we can also measure different stopping potential for different filters using this Planck constant measuring instrument. So basically this is a frequency in the terms of 10 to the power 14. These frequencies are measured from the formula using mu equals to c by lambda, where c is a light velocity and where lambda is a wavelength of different filters. So now we made this observation table on this graph, where in this graph x-axis represent the frequency, that is mu, and where y-axis is represent the stopping potential and also we can say deaccelerating voltage. So basically delta mu is 2.0 into 10 to the power 14, whereas delta Vs is equals to 0.825 volt. These are the basically difference of frequencies and voltages. So now Planck constant formula as given in the manual is H equals to E delta Vs upon delta nu, where E is the charge of electron, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, and delta Vs from the graph, it is a change in the stopping potential, whereas delta nu in this graph, it is a change of frequencies. So we put the values and we can get the value of H, that is 6.61 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule seconds. So similarly, you can also measure the Planck constant value using our instrument as I described in my video. So thank you, and for further queries you can contact Tescar Technologies Private Limited.